welcome to another edition of Solutions in Six series. I'm super excited to bring our special guest today, introduce our special guest today, our virtualization guru, ransomware guru, a surviving VCP and a 10x vExpert. Let me get it right. Yeah, 10x vExpert. Andrew. Hey, Andrew. Like, I remember you doing a lot of storage architecture back in the day, right? Do you want to go over like what you used to do then and like some pointers to friends here?
Absolutely happy to. I definitely appreciate it. Well, I put it in there, the vExpert community over the last 10 years. It's been through a lot of the changes in my career and met so many good folks there. But to your point, a lot of work over the years around VMware storage and VMware architecture for storage across a couple different platforms. It's been more than fair, actually. So when I think about that, there is a bunch of stuff that comes to mind that I used to plan around. You know, there's some big high-level categories, to be real. Sometimes we think about optimizing for cost. We think about optimizing for availability. You know, we think about optimizing for performance. Okay, those are all legitimate things, and I'll get out of the way there for just a second so you can see those cost, availability, and performance. But then there's all these other things that we dive into a layer down. So we're thinking about maybe data reduction, deduplication and compression, on or off. What's the performance impact of that stuff? If I'm thinking about, you know, what level of protection do I need from a RAID level perspective, or even overall resiliency, 5, 6, 7, 9s based on the application? Do I need encryption or not? Or can I change my mind on that down the road? Is there performance impact when I do it? What's even the latency profile? You know, sub millisecond, 5, 10 milliseconds, and even not just what's the latency profile, but what's the predictability of that latency? Isn't it going to be consistent? Sometimes I look at, you know, I've got different tiers of storage and will things move around in maybe unpredictable ways? And then of course, last but not least, noisy neighbor. Do I have, you know, co-located VMs that are going to step on each other? And if I'm doing upgrades, what does performance look like during that? How do I have to plan for and schedule downage windows? So that's this, it's almost like this laundry list of stuff. There's a lot of stuff to think about and plan for when it comes into VMware storage design.
I mean, that's great. I know you talked a lot about the challenges, right? Can you take us to that orange place where, you know, what does this look like with FlashArray?
Yep.
Cool.
So as we think about that with FlashArray, and we're making a bold claim here, you know, or putting it out there, kind of, you know, is FlashArray the best VMware storage? The reason, and so much of what I've done in the past is what goes in here. Thinking about nothing to tune and not having trade-offs being ideal for all workloads. It's like it says on the slide, or if we're going to have fun with memes, current memes, you know, so, you know, ancient Star Wars movies, you know, if you're architecting storage for my VMware environment, and, you know, maybe if you're not using FlashArray, someone might look at you a little bit funny, you know, kind of thing. But why is that, though? Let's take some of those same categories and kind of walk a step down. So we think about cost optimized, because that's always a big category. So from a pure standpoint, there's automatic data reduction. This is both inline and post-process, deduplication and compression. We don't have to think about configuring RAID levels. It's always N+2. We don't have to think about aggregates and storage pools and all this kind of stuff. Updates are delivered via the cloud. And even a simplicity of upgrade standpoint that doesn't have performance impact. And then we think about, you know, what's the same multipathing. That gets down in the weeds, but actually optimized around the native MPIO approach, round robin equals one for ESX multipathing. Continuing on. So we think about optimizing for availability. So Pure not only has a very highly available architecture, even through upgrades, there's not downtime, but we're now at the point where we can talk about having 7 nines of uptime from a fleet-wide perspective. Want to have a little bit of fun with math? 7 nines is actually 3.5 seconds. What that actually means is that most of our customers have no downtime. There are some that do, but it only pulls the average down enough that it's 7 nines. And we're not taking the cheat card there of taking out planned downages for planned time for either planned upgrades or downages or data center moves. Always N+2 data protection. Encryption is always on, period. You can't turn it off. We actually use it in some ways for wear leveling. That actually helps out in some neat ways. And then, of course, we think about performance optimized. So, you know, I'll get out of the way here a little bit for a second. Consistently sub-millisecond latency on FlashArray X. If we want to have a different level, we can talk about FlashArray C at a different price point that has great latency as well. QoS is always on to help with noisy neighbors. And, you know, calling it out again because it matters, 100% performance through failures and maintenance. Is very cool. There's a lot of hard architecture there, and it's neat to sometimes go into how NPIV works, the active standby controller architecture. It even goes some back to the core architectural decisions that we made with Pure, going back to the very founding of the company.
So I know these are all cool, Andrew, and like there are some customer related points here as well on like the availability and uptime. But I mean, this is all from pure vantage point. Since we are talking about VMware here, right? What does VMware have to say about this?
Just kind of flip it around. So I can say cool things about Pure. Hopefully I sound kind of credible as I say it. But what's actually neat there is that, you know, if we look at our relationship with VMware as Pure, we have design partnerships in multiple areas. You know, we're a design partner around vVols with VMware Cloud Foundation, NVMe over Fabrics, pushing that forward as a transport layer, VMware Cloud Native Solutions, great work we do together, and even Site Recovery Manager, you know, actually developing that out and doing work with VMware, where a lot of the development is done for Site Recovery Manager on top of Pure products and making sure of compatibility. Then, if we go one step further, you know, we think about vVols. I mentioned it there. But, you know, there's this gentleman named Lee Caswell. He's a VP of marketing for Cloud Platform BU. So he knows a little bit about vVols. And, you know, he's on record as saying, literally a quote here, that Pure is the number one platform for vVols deployed. It's really cool. Of course, if you want to try this stuff out, I think you've got a couple thoughts there.
Oh, yeah. So, I mean, if you want to test all the things that Andrew just said and want to decide if FlashArray is the best storage for VMware, just pop onto our website, purestorage.com, and click on that big TryNav logo on the website. And thank you. Thank you so much, Andrew, for talking about VMware and pulling up your 10x vExpert expertise out. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Brady. Thanks for listening.